Hey guys, this is Dr. Sangeeta from Dental Pathshala, where we help you understand and learn dentistry better and easy way. First of all, I would like to thank you all guys for the love and the support and to keep me motivating to put more videos even in the sore throat, even in the throat pain. So thank you all who have subscribed. Thank you all for your love and support. So today's video is about the pulpectomy in the primary teeth. Pulpectomy is a very simple procedure. It is just like a root canal treatment we are doing in a primary teeth. So without further ado, let's get started. So before we get started with pulpectomy, make sure you subscribe to this channel and click on the bell icon. That way you get a notification as soon as I release a video lecture, which I do every day. So coming to pulpectomy is a procedure wherein we remove the pulp, we remove the roof and the pulp chamber in order to gain access to the root canals. So we are doing root canal treatment. Actually, the root canals are cleaned. Root canals are cleaned and debrided, enlarged and disinfected, and then they are filled with the resorbable material. Now, difference between the root canal procedure, the RCT, and the pulpectomy in the primary teeth is root canal when we are doing in the permanent teeth and pulpectomy when we are doing in the primary teeth is little bit different. As in the pulpectomy procedure, we are putting a resorbable material because there is a physiologic root resorption which is happening in the primary teeth as the primary teeth shed on their own, on its own time. So pulpectomy procedure, we are putting a resorbable material, while on the other hand, in the RCT, we are putting a radio opaque material. So this is the difference between the root canal of the permanent and the primary teeth. Now talking about the pulpectomy procedure, we are removing the roof and the pulp chamber in order to access to the root canals. Now the main objective for doing a pulpectomy in the primary teeth is removing the infection which has crossed the pulp, which has invaded the pulp, and there should be radiographic evidence that the success of the filling material is without over extension or under extension, and it resorbs with time as the root resorption occurs. So this is about the pulpectomy procedure. Now wherein we do this pulpectomy procedure, this is very important for you to know, because the primary teeth with necrotic pulp, or if the canal is accessible, because reaching a canal in a primary tooth is actually difficult. Doing a root canal in a permanent teeth is easier than doing a root canal in a primary teeth. Now if the bone should be normal, bone should not be compromised. In case if the bone is compromised, then the root canal treatment or the pulpectomy procedure is going to fail. Now in case of a second primary molar, if we talk about the E teeth, so the second primary molar if is lost before eruption of our six, so the if the second primary molar is lost before eruption of the first permanent molar, then the first permanent molar is going to drift mesially. And when the first permanent molar is going to drift mesially during the eruption, there will be no space for the premolars. So it is very, very, very important for us to preserve this space for premolars. Otherwise, there will be crowding, and this differentiates between the orthodontic extraction, if we have to do the orthodontic extraction or not. So this space, every millimeter of this space is very important. That is why it is important that we save this E teeth, that we save the second deciduous molar. And in order to save the second deciduous molar, if we have to do the root canal treatment, that means if we have to go for the pulpectomy procedure also, that's okay with us. We are ready to do it because we want to, our ultimate aim is to save the second deciduous molar, is to save the E. So wherein this pulpectomy procedure is contraindicated, where there is a non-resorbable tooth, where there is mobility, where there is reduced bone, where there is PDL widening, all these cases, or in case of a medically compromised patient, or if the root less than two-thirds of the root length is remaining, most of the root is resorbed, only less than two-thirds of the root is remaining, then also we don't go for pulpectomy procedure. Now all the procedure we have done till now, we have done the IDPC, indirect pulp capping, we have done the direct pulp capping, also we have done the pulpotomy procedure. All these procedures, the pulp was vital, we were saving the pulp, the pulp was living. So the pulpectomy procedure is dead because we are removing all of the pulp. There is the debridement of the pulp, then we enlarge it, disinfect it. Basically, there is no pulp left in the tooth. That is why it is a non-vital pulp therapy. So as we do like all the procedures, the step is same. Rubber dam is first placed, the roof of the pulp chamber is removed. Then we get the access to the root canal. Once we get the access to the root canal, the content of the pulp chamber are removed from occlusal 1/3 to the apical level because we don't want to push the infection into periapical areas. So we are removing the from the occlusal 1/3 in order to avoid forcing the infection into the apex through the apical foramen. We don't want this to happen. So we are removing slowly, and then the palate, moistened cotton palate with the CMCP paste. Now we have something new in here. Otherwise, we were just reading about calcium hydroxide everywhere and filling with the zinc oxide eugenol, right? But in that, in the pulpectomy procedure, we are using the CMCP paste, which is a camphorated monochlorophenol. And we are also using 1:5 concentration of Buckley's formula. If you remember, every previous video while studying about the pulpectomy procedure, we have already studied 1:5 concentration of the Buckley's formocrisol formula. We remove it, we actually moist the petal, the palate moistened, cotton palate moistened with either of this paste. We place it and then we seal the root canals with a zinc oxide eugenol cement. Now this is one of the most commonly used filling material, root canal filling material for a primary teeth. There are also other materials which we'll study, but this is the most commonly which we used, and calcium hydroxide is never used in a primary teeth. You have to make this in mind, because for IDPC, indirect pulp capping, we used calcium hydroxide. For direct pulp capping, we used calcium hydroxide. But remember, in primary teeth, we are not putting calcium hydroxide anywhere in the pulp. So remember this thing in mind, that we are not putting calcium hydroxide. So this is the zinc oxide eugenol which we are putting, and several days later we call the patient for second appointment. Then we again place the rubber dam and we remove the cotton palate, and if the patient is symptomatic at this point of time, the apex of the root is penetrated with the smallest file, and then we repeat the whole procedure like what we did in the step one in the first sitting. And if the patient is asymptomatic, then canal is prepared and the canal is filled with the root canal filling material with the ZOE. Now, pulpectomy procedure, most of the authors, most of the clinician, the experienced clinician, they prefer to do it in a single appointment. But on the other hand, some unexperienced clinicians, they actually on the safe side they play, and if there is any painful necrosis, if the purulence is present in the canal, then we do it in 2 or 3 visits. So it is mostly done in the single sitting appointment. So for root canal filling material for primary teeth, we have many agent which we use for a root canal filling material, and the most common one is our CMCP paste. And other than that, we also have something known as Volkoff's paste. Now this Volkoff's paste contain parachlorophenol, camphorquinone and menthol, and there is something known as KRI paste which we have studied in the pulpotomy as well. So in the KRI paste, is iodoform is there, camphor is there, and parachlorophenol and menthol is there. Also we have something known as miesto paste. So miesto paste contains zinc oxide as well as it contains iodoform, thymol and many agents. So like that we have miesto paste, Vetapex, endoflask. So like these all are the root canal filling material which we use for a primary teeth. Just remember one thing, that calcium hydroxide and gutta percha is never used for our primary teeth. We never use both of these agents for our primary teeth, because gutta percha is non-resorbable and calcium hydroxide causes internal resorption of the teeth. So that's why we don't use these material for pulpectomy procedure, and we are removing whole of the pulp. We are removing from the pulp chamber, from the root canals. So this differentiates from the pulpectomy, from pulpotomy. In the pulpotomy, we removed only the coronal portion of the pulp. So radicular portion of the pulp was saved in the pulpotomy. While on the other hand, ectomy means we are removing the whole of the pulp. So this is, and we use it, we do this procedure when the injury is more than 74 hours. So this is all about the pulpectomy procedure in the primary teeth, and pulpectomy procedure in the permanent teeth is known as the root canal therapy. So this is all about it. So if you feel that I have made it easier for you, then go ahead and hit the like button and the comment box, because this helped me to help you with your exams, career and knowledge while you stay at home in the lockdown with your family.